DM7 series is one of the most versatile mixing consoles when it comes to live audio recording, production, and playback. It makes virtual sound checks easier than ever. Let's see how it's done. Before we move on to multi-tracks, let's take a look at stereo recording using the top panel USB port. Insert a USB drive which is formatted with either FAT16, FAT32 or XFAT. If you're not sure how it's formatted, you can do it in the Save Load menu. Open the DM7's menu bar and select Recorder. The desired file format can be selected near the bottom. WAV or MP3, 48 kHz or 96 kHz. At the top of the screen, you can switch between USB ports 1 and 2. Though you can only use one at a time for the recorder functions. Use the other one for console file storage. See the folder path and the available space on the drive. For a 48 kHz WAV file, you will need about 1 GB of storage per hour of recording. Double that for 96 kHz. On the left of the screen, select the two mono channels or one stereo channel you wish to record, or select a pair of input ports. Main stereo A is the default. Adjust the gain if you need to and take a listen in the cue bus. To play back a file, you can select a pair of channels on the right side of the screen, or just use cue to listen on headphones. The simplest way to do multi-track recording with DM7 is to use the USB-C to host port on the rear. This is USB 2.0 standard and can carry 18 channels to and from a computer. Use a Windows or macOS machine. You'll need the latest Yamaha Steinberg USB driver from our website, and I recommend to use Nuendo Live 3 multi-track recording software, which is included with DM7 series. This is a really slick, simple, and secure way to capture a lot of audio data and then play it back through the console later. Let's first set up the DM7 recording patch to use the USB port. Open the patch screen and select Recording. If you want to record the inputs of channels 1 to 18, it's going to be quick. Touch the Recording Out box for channel 1. Set the sequential patch to 18 and select USB port 1. All 18 USB outputs will be patched. The pickoff point for the recording patch is pre-D gain, so before any digital signal processing occurs. DM7 series has the ability to control a range of digital audio workstation functions and even transfer its channel names and colors, so long as you have installed the Yamaha console extension, available from our website downloads. So I advise you to get that running before creating a Nuendo Live project. It only needs to be installed. There's no extra configuring to do. Back on the console, open the menu and select Live Rec. Touch the information display above the transport controls, which most likely will say no assign, to configure the communication with Nuendo Live. So this opens the DAW Remote Setup screen. Select Steinberg as the DAW Remote mode at the top, and select USB on the left as the communication method. Touch OK. We'll come back to this page in a moment, because now we're ready to set up Nuendo Live, which is one of the easiest multi-track recorders to configure. When you start it, select Yamaha DM7 as the ASIO driver. If you see the high precision option, that supports 32-bit audio recording, which we don't really need here. When you create a new project, open the settings and select the desired sample rate. Also, set the output mode to multi-track. When the project is created, you will see 18 tracks patched, colored, and named ready for you. Open the record panel to see useful data about available recording time on the computer's drive, and find the shortcut buttons to arm all tracks, locate end, and start recording. Easy Record does all those actions in sequence and locks the computer keyboard to prevent accidental stoppages. To unlock, hold down Command and press Return, or click with the pointer. Back on the DM7, you can see the same transport controls and timers on the Live Rec screen, with the Easy Record shortcut and safety lock. Above that is the list of all the markers you may create while recording, perhaps one for each song or scene. Enable Recall Link to create a marker every time a console's scene is recalled. This is excellent, but I know what you're thinking. 18 channels via USB isn't going to capture a full band. So let's graduate up to 64 channels via Dante, using Dante Virtual Soundcard on a computer, which can carry 32 channels in and out at 96 kHz, or 64 channels at 48 kHz. We shall have to reset the recording patch and the DAW remote setup. But before that, connect the computer to the Dante network and install Dante Virtual Soundcard and Dante Controller software, available from Audinate's website. If you don't have any other Dante devices, you could use just one network cable from the computer to the Dante primary port. I talk about Dante setup elsewhere, so I won't go into details here. Just ensure DVS is mounted as a Dante I/O device in the console. That allows us control of the patching and remote control of the DAW software. Let me show you the Dante patch I have made for my system. I have Dante inputs 1 to 64 coming from two RIO3224D2 units on stage. So I shall use Dante inputs 65 to 128 for the computer. Looking at the output patch for DVS, I can make a sequential patch to assign Dante outputs 65 to 128. It's really useful having so many channels available on the Dante port. So, that's the Dante patch created in the network. Now we need to make the recording patch in the console. Go back to the recording patch screen. Use a sequential patch function to assign 64 channels, starting with the recording out for input channel 1, going to Dante port 65. Do the same for the playback in patch. Dante 65 to 128. Return to the live rec screen and replace the USB setting with DVS. In case there are several DVS devices showing, select the correct one and touch OK. Start Nuendo Live again and choose Dante Virtual Soundcard as the audio driver. Create a new project and see the channel names and colors appear again. But this time, there will be 64 channels. The live rec screen will again provide control from the console. Now, the beauty of using the recording patch rather than the direct outputs is that it's easy to play back the audio later through the same channels and processing that was used for the live performance. In the recording patch screen, activate virtual sound check. This will temporarily replace all the regular input channel patches with the playback in patch. Though you probably don't want to do that for all channels, as it would block the effects returns. So scroll down to those channels and switch VSC off for them. If you want to edit parameters and update scenes while running the virtual sound check, go ahead with confidence. The scenes will store with the normal patching rather than with this playback patch. Just disable VSC when you're finished and return to mixing the live sound from the stage. If you wish to combine some live channels with some playback, just exclude the live channels from the virtual sound check playback in. VSC can be disabled for specific channels in the input gain screen. The recording out patch will still be active, so no worries about missing that next time. Of course, 64 channels of multi-track recording isn't always enough, and DM7 series can support more. Though, in that case, a solution other than Dante Virtual Soundcard would be needed. There are Dante devices based on PCIe cards and on USB-C connections which can handle 128 or more channels at 96 kHz, so do bear those in mind. Remote control of Nuendo Live will still be possible using a regular network connection. In the DAW Remote Setup, you would need to specify the IP address of the PC manually to obtain control. Live recording with DM7 series provides versatile options, and a high channel count at 96 kHz is possible with the right choice of system. I'm sure you're going to find it useful at a wide range of events and productions. Don't miss my videos about DM7 series Dante setup and learn more about the special broadcast and theatre packages. Bye for now.